love somebody sometime.
Good tonight. Yeah, I got up at 7 o'clock this morning and took a nice long ride. I didn't plan it that way, but my kid Ricky left his roller skates in the shower. But I had a perfect day today. Jeannie and my kids and the maid were all out, and I was in the house all alone. And, you know, being alone in the house, I really learned something. Those Avon ladies are real good sports boys. Yeah, I didn't know that. I'm staying home. Well, my Jeannie's, she real steamed at me. A couple of days ago, she had a phone installed in my car. Well, about 2 o'clock this morning, she called me, and that's why she steamed at me. My secretary answered. I don't know these either. I'm just reading them, so if they're good, I'll laugh with you. I don't know these things at all. Yeah. When I finally got home, yeah, she threw a pot at me, missed, and hit the cuckoo clock. And about 3 hours later, the cuckoo came out, woke us up, and asked, does anybody know what time it is? Then they tell you about the birds and the bees, the flowers and the trees, the moon up above, and a thing called love. Let me tell you about the stars in the sky, the girl and the guy, the way that they kiss on a night like this. When I look into your big brown eyes, it is very plain to see that it's time you learned about the facts of life, starting from A to Z. Let me tell you about the birds and the bees, the flowers and the trees, the moon up above, and a thing called love. Tell you about the bird, the bee, the flowers and the tree, stars in the sky, the girl and the guy, the birds and the bee, the flowers and the tree, anything called love.
I don't believe it.
Beautiful. The kid is a singer of song. He sings absolutely beautiful. And they ought to have guided tours of his throat.
Throat. You got an H in throat. Throat. Yeah, it sure is good to be back. For my third year on Nebek, Nebek? NBC, you stick a period in after everything there. Nebek. And they're so nice to me. They told me to treat this place like it was my own home. And I do. I show up once a week. Nebek is all... NBC... is always doing nice things for me. Yesterday, after rehearsal, they gave me a brand new car. I drove it today, and it's a beauty. After the show, when you go through the parking lot, take a look at it. You can't miss it. It's that red convertible on top of the green station wagon.
Juliet Krause, I'm ready for my dance lesson.
Well, good. You're certainly dressed for it.
Mm-hmm. We dressed like this in Stubenville for dance lessons.
Oh, you did?
We did. Yes. I did the Australian crawl, you know.
Hey, wonderful. Now, I always start out by limbering at a bar.
Yeah, baby. So do I. Right, I always do that. That's when I do the Australian crawl, you know.
You do?
Oh, yeah. Oh,
ladies.
I'm not a lady.
Can we have a bar, please?
Oh. Oh.
This is my bar.
This is your bar?
This is my bar. I frequent it.
Oh.
Frequently.
You do.
So to speak.
Oh, I love your point work.
Now, first we better limber up a little. Put your hand right here, and we'll do some pliés, okay?
We're going to do some waddies?
Pliés.
Pliés, oh.
Second position.
Second? What happened to the first one, baby?
Okay. Here we go.
Bend
and hey, that's pretty good. Deeper. Down and just a little deeper. There you go. How's that feel?
I think I got my shorts on backwards.
Try this. Put your foot up on the bar.
On the bar.
And your hands above your head.
Uh-huh.
And you put your head down on your knees.
On your knees.
Well, come on now, you can get there.
Sorry. Well, I'm hurting my tutu here. I'm sorry. I can't do that stuff.
No?
Look, why don't we do a dance like a nice, you know, boy and girl dance? Just put our arms around each other and things, you know.
Hey, I never thought of that.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
I'm in heaven.
It's very nice, Dean.
I'm in heaven.
Dancing like this.
And my heart beats so that I can hardly speak.
Oh, I feel so weak.
And I seem to find the happiness I see.
I love your aftershave.
When we're out together, dancing cheek to cheek. Heaven.
Do you mind, Dean?
Heaven.
My holding you tight.
And the cares that hung around me through the week.
You have a nice physique.
Seem to vanish like a gambler's lucky streak.
Why don't you try to relax?
When we're out together, dancing cheek to cheek.
Telegram. Mr. Orson Welles, Paris, France. Dear Orson, I would consider it an honor if you would find the time to appear on my opening television show, Dean Martin. Of course, I was delighted, but I've never done this kind of show before, and I wanted to make sure I'd have enough rehearsal, so I wired back, please advise me of my rehearsal dates. And this is what I got back from Dean. Dear Orson, your rehearsal dates will be Kathy, Margie, and Roberta in that order. That's my kind of a guy. So here I am. And I must say that in all my years in movies and on the stage, I've never seen anything quite like it, except maybe from my days in radio. I didn't rehearse then either. But it was for a different reason. We were doing so many shows in those days, there wasn't time to rehearse. I can remember NBC in New York, I was acting in 30 different radio shows a week, and they had an elevator set aside just to get me from studio to studio on time. That's really true. As I was leaving the elevator, someone would throw a script in my hands and say, page 36, you're a 90-year-old cowboy. And I'd say, it's awful lonesome up here in the saddle ever since my old horse died. And back to the elevator to another studio where I'd be a doctor. I hate to disillusion you, nurse, but an apple a day will not keep me away. And down 6 floors to Studio A and Fu Manchu. Cause of death was ancient Chinese murder weapon. Victim beaten to death with soggy egg roll. And down the hall to Studio B, where I was in a soap opera. You know, in that soap opera, I had a girl in the rumble seat of a car for 30 weeks. And what really went on in that rumble seat, only the shadow knew. Oh, yes, the shadow. I was the shadow. Who knows what evil lurks in the hearts of men? The shadow knows. Thank you, senior citizens. The shadow, which I was for my sins, may have known what was going on, but I didn't. I was too busy. They were great days. There was a lot of excitement in radio. There really was, because there was a lot of imagination in it. We could create a whole world in the mind of the listener simply by using sound effects. But on some of the big shows, there were as many as 6 different sound men all running around like cooks in the Waldorf kitchen, while we actors stood quite calmly by reading our lines in the microphone. I'll never forget one day we had a blizzard in New York. Only one of the 6 sound men was able to get through the snow to the studio, one lone and rather sorrowful character. The whole thing was impossible. Let me show you.
The NBC Blue Network brings you another episode of Johnny Pistachio, Private Eye.
The city was asleep as I returned to my apartment. Everything was quiet. Except for the occasional sound of a tugboat in the East River. And once in a while, a taxi below my window. The tower clock was striking 3. My skull throbbed from the pistol whipping I'd taken as I tossed my shoes on the floor and jumped into bed. Then it hit me. I'd left the office open, and inside that office was enough evidence to put the mob away for life. I jumped out of bed, grabbed my shoes, and ran downstairs, right into the middle of a thunderstorm. I sloshed my way through the rain-drenched street. When I reached my office, I opened the door slowly, slowly, and tiptoed in. There was someone coming. I heard footsteps on the stairs. A woman's footsteps. And then she walked in the door. I have never seen a more beautiful woman in my life. She walked through the door, and then she kissed me. She kissed me, but not an ordinary kiss. No, the kind of kiss a man remembers. There was a pregnant pause. She slumped to the floor, but someone had called the cops. The cops. Someone had called the cops. I had to hide the body. The body, but where? The closet. No, out the window would be better. Out the window. Wait a minute. I better stick with the closet. Of course, it could look like an accident if I rolled the body down the stairs. Forget it. I ran out the door and beat it down the back stairs. All 3 flights. Then just as the police were running down the front stairs, I somehow made it back to my apartment and flopped on the bed. As an afterthought, I mixed myself a good short drink. Just a short one. Thank you, I needed that.
You know, I owe a lot to Dean. He not only gave me my first show as his summer replacement, but I was a regular on his variety show. And What a good time we had. Dean was dependable and unpredictable. You could depend that he was going to show up, but you could never predict what was going to happen. I remember one time I said to him, Dean, you're Italian, I'm Italian. Isn't it wonderful, Italians working together? The next week, he had on Gina Lollobrigida.
You enjoy America? You like America?
Oh, I love America.
E perché
it's the
why?
Only, it's the only place in the world where you can get a good pizza. Yes.
A good pizza what?
But there is one thing I don't understand about America.
All right, you ask me. I know everything about America. Just you ask me.
Why is everyone so crazy about baseball?
Why? Well, that's our national outdoor sport, baseball.
In Italy, the national sport is love. And it's much, much better.
Why?
You don't even need a uniform.
Well, here, you know, the men play and the women watch.
Oh! How is possible?
How is possible?
Well, confusing,
I know,
huh?
It's confusing, but well, it's the simplest game in the world. Here, let me show. Oh, could I have a bat, please? Oh. Thank you.
What is this stick?
Well, this is a bat, see? Now, first of all, the main idea is to get to first base, you know?
Oh, that I understand. Same as in Italy.
Listen to this little contest of Dean's and see if you think that anyone would take it seriously. Do you know that a lot of people did? And to everyone's surprise, I mean, we couldn't believe it when the post office delivered to Dean 27 piano tops.
You know, incidentally, we've had over 375,000 entries in my mystery voice contest, and nobody, and I mean, nobody has recognized my mystery voice yet. So listen close, because here it is again. This is the last time. Now, this is the mystery voice. Listen.
Ever since that night, we've been together, love is at my side. In love forever, it turned out so right for strangers in the night.
He says, dooby-dooby, I'm gonna die.
Scotty-wowdy-dooby-doo.
How can anybody end the song with dooby-dooby? Now, come on, out there in television land. Somebody must know who that cat is. So you just send in your entry tonight. It's easy to enter. You just tear off the top of your piano and send it in.
Excuse me, you a doctor?
No, sir, no. No, oh. I'm a specialist.
Oh, what do you specialize in?
I specialize in sick people, sir.
Oh, well, you're just the man I'm looking for. I haven't been feeling myself.
Oh, who have you been feeling?
What I mean is I feel terrible. Tired all the time.
Oh, well, you better sit down, then.
But there's no chair.
Ah, well, if you're that tired, then why didn't you bring one with you? I better, first of all, ask you some preliminary questions now. Now, first of all, do you have any broken bones?
No.
You don't? All right, well, here, have one of mine. Now, how about this? Does it hurt? Tell me.
No.
All right. How about that? No, how is that done?
Yeah, that hurts.
You'll have to see a doctor about that, you know. You really will. Hang on a second. I want to give my wife a buzz on the telephone. Hello, darling. Buzz.
Yeah. What does that do for her?
It breaks up a day for her, you know.
Oh. A lot of husbands don't call at all.
Yes, yes, no. Stick out your tongue, will you? And the same to you, too. Oh. Yeah. Can you have an eye test now? Can you see the chart on the wall? Read that chart on the wall.
There is no chart on the wall.
Yes, you've passed that all right. You've passed that. Would you mind if I take a blood sample?
Not at all. Go right ahead.
Yes, would you rather than that I prick your finger or I bit your neck?
The finger, if you don't mind.
Yes, all right. Put your hand on there, dear, because this could be the start of a meaningful relationship. You know what I mean? Hang on a second. I got to hit one, right? Now, ready?
What are you doing?
I got it there. This thing's a microscope, you see. Now, listen. And I get it in focus. Oh.
What is it, Doc?
Oh.
What is it?
It's standing on my foot.
Oh.
What have I got?
Are you prepared for this, sir? It's a terrible thing I have to tell you. But it's a terrible thing, but it's better that you know. You're suffering from elephants. And
elephants?
Elephants, yeah. And to make it worse, you've got them low down. Would you?
I've got them low down?
Yes, that's the worst place to have them, you know. Would you like to see for yourself?
Now, I'm going to look at my elephants?
Have a look. They're on the blood sample. You'll see them clearly.
Yes. Is there any cure?
The only known cure for them is mice. Yes. Have another look in there. Look now. Let's get out of here. They got wind of us. Oh, sorry.
When I was very young, the world was younger than I, as merry as a carousel. The circus tents were strung with every star in the sky. Above the ring I loved so well. Now the young world has grown old. Gone are the tinsel and gold. Sit there. Your hope is slender. Why won't somebody send a tender blue boy?
With Peggy Lee, it's kind of like, my goodness, I'm working with a legend. Look how lucky I am. I'm working with Peggy Lee. And that, of course, she is.
Not only talk, Happy, she sings, Happy, walks, everything is Happy. Peggy, you sing prettier than ever. You sure do make beautiful music.
Thank you, dear.
It's all right, Peg. Everybody
Peggy Lee, maybe the most charming lady you'll ever want to stand next to while she's singing or talking. Or drinking a cup of tea, or whatever it is she's doing.
Just you, just me. We'll sing some swinging song. Just you, just me.
In the number with Peggy Lee, you're gonna be watching Dean on to Peggy's right. He always liked to work on the right. And I don't know why, but I guess if you watch the early Jerry Lewis clips, he always worked on Jerry's right, so we stayed with it. He's looking at her. He's not singing to the camera. He's performing to Peggy. He's not performing to the camera going, hey, I'm looking to... He's performing to the person that he's with.
Well, I want to show it to you. No one does this love scene exactly like you.
We generally kept a two-shot. Rarely did we ever cut away. Rarely, you know. And so it's a performance. Two people. The two people are working together. And they suddenly become one.
I would gather stars out of the blue just for you, only you.
The very thought of you, and I forget to do the little ordinary things that anyone ought to do.
I see your face in every flower, your eyes and skies above.
It's just the thought of you, the very thought of you,
my love.
You,
yes,
you're driving me crazy.
What did I do? What did I do? My love for you makes everything hazy.
That's what I do.
Cry when you cry, and you smile when you smile, and I'll be happy.
Oh, gee, what are your charms for? What are your arms for? Use your imagination.
Just you, just me. We've had a swinging time, just you and just me.
Just you,
just you,
just me,
just me.
And I know.
Now this is what we call documentary comedy, you see? And the world isn't ready for it yet, but I don't care. It doesn't bother me at all. I'd rather tell you the truth. I'll tell you something else about this song. Now, you know the thing that really sells a song is the ending. That's what sells it. Really, if it wasn't for the ending, I wouldn't fool with this song at all. But the ending... Matter of fact, a lot of times I just sing the ending of the song. A lot of times. Matter of fact, tonight, as long as I've explained the whole thing to you, it's silly to do the whole song, you know, but I wouldn't. I would like to have you hear the ending because it is quite effective. That is, if I can get started near the end. I don't know about that. Les, if I can speak to the piano player direct, I'd like to say, a piano player, if you could play me some sort of a arpeggio, you know, that would get me started, sibirial bars from the end. Now, that was perfect. It was just right. It was just enough, and it wasn't overdone, and it was in good taste, I think. But what's the starting note of it? He is cooperative. It's a good thing I got perfect pitch because that pitch pipe is out of tune. You know? It's got a tremolo in there. You know? Create a mood here. Huh? You laugh at a sensitive performer when he's trying to. That cut me to the quick. Now I'll have to go all through life with a cut quick. Thank you very much. I appreciate
sorry.
It.
Sorry. You'd have never made that note if they didn't that way.
When we're together, I want you to come in a room and I want to see that quick of yours, Al. I've seen a lot of cut quicks, but yours should be a quick. And
in the meantime, how's Alice?
Well, I guess it don't make a lot of difference now. I don't think so. As long as you brought it up, you know.
Does she know about your...
Yeah, as long as you brought it up, you know. I mean, you know, we can wing better stuff than they write on these cards.
Yes, sir, I guarantee it.
Of course, a lot of it gets cut, you know.
I know. But how is Alice, you know?
Alice, well, she's about the same as when you last saw her.
Oh, that's a shame, George. Yeah.
You can't win them all. That's what I always say. How's your wife, Jeannie?
Oh. Really? Well, she's still a little sore about the accident last night.
What accident?
The one I didn't have. That's what it was.
Oh, nice. Well, uh-huh. I guess we might as well go through with it now, huh? Shall we go
we
ahead and
well
do this song?
We might as well go through with it. We rehearsed it once.
I did. There's a hole in the bucket, dear Dino, there's a hole in the bucket, dear Dino, a hole.
We'll fix it, dear Georgie, dear Georgie, dear Georgie, we'll fix it, dear Georgie, fix it.
With what shall I fix it, dear Dino, with what shall I fix it, dear Dino, with what?
With a twig, dear Georgie, with a twig, dear Georgie, with a twig.
With what shall I cut it, dear Dino, with what shall I cut it, dear Dino, with what?
with you quick, dear Johnson. Dear Georgie, with an axe. Dear Georgie, with an axe.
With what shall I wet it, dear Dino, with what shall I wet it, dear Dino, with what?
With water, dear Georgie, dear Georgie, with water, dear Georgie, with water.
In what will I fetch it, dear Dino, in what will I fetch it, dear Dino, in what?
In a bucket, dear Georgie, dear Georgie, dear Georgie, in a bucket, dear Georgie, in a
bucket. Hey, you know what? There's a hole in the bucket, dear Dino, there's a hole in the bucket, dear Dino. Oh,
oh, yeah. This is George Gova. You.
These days, anyhow.
Okay. You all know my old pal Ken Lane. You were in on this, huh?
I used to know it.
You know, Ken doesn't have to do this for a living. He's got a great new invention. It's a windshield wiper that won't hold parking tickets. Or a piano that won't hold me, I tell you.
Okay.
Something is someplace where it ain't supposed to be, I'll tell you that. All right.
Return to me. I got a sink full of dishes.
Where'd we get that one?
Must we dance? Every dance. I got a big hole in my pants.
I'm afraid to get off of here. Well, I think I'll go to the couch and I'm gonna sing a little. Okay, I'm afraid to open the thing here.
Your wife coming here, but tell her to sit in the audience, would you?
Welcome to my world. Won't you come on in? Miracles, I give. Still happen now and then. Step into my heart and leave your cares behind. Welcome to my world. Filled with you in mind. Knock and the door will open seek, and you will find. Ask, and you'll be given the key to this world of mine. I'll be waiting here with my arms unfurled, waiting just for you. Welcome to my world.
Waiting just for you.
Welcome to my world.
Here's the first time that Dean and I work together, and what a great assistant.
The people up front gonna be fascinated. The one in the back are gonna like it too. Just control yourselves as much as you can. For my first trick, I need to volunteer. Can I have just one volunteer, please? Anybody at all? Would be nice. Oh, thank you so much, sir. This man, I don't know him. He came right out of the audience. Ladies and gentlemen, before your very eyes, a top of hat. Thank you very much, Ralph.
Ralph's got the mumps.
May she never get well. You know, I tell you the truth, Ralph is just her stage name. Her real name is Bruce. Okay. Excuse me, sir, we haven't met it before.
Meet it?
No, in other words, you and me, we know each other from afar before. Okay, simmer down.
No, we don't know anybody from Big Fair. But I've never seen you before in my life.
Good. Now, please tell the audience if the top hat is empty.
What hat?
This over here.
Oh, hat. Is it empty?
Yes.
No, ashes. Yes, empty.
But other than that?
Empty.
Yes.
Yes.
Just to show you that there's no kidding around. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, before your very eyes, one, two, three. Now, the trick ain't over. Ladies and gentlemen, inside of the hat is gonna go like this. Now, the ladies and gentlemen, listen.
That was a good, swell trick.
It was a nice trick. It was a nice... Okay, listen, you know, magic, you know, so...
Magic trick. Now, what? What?
Wait.
What?
I want to clear myself.
Okay.
How was that a big finish? That's a beautiful mirror. Mirror, mirror, all so bright. Let's have no accident tonight. That's a bowl. Ah! Okay. Touch me. One, two, three. Okay.
It's double park.
Now we're gonna do one blindfold.
Just a second.
How come you always brought a knife?
Because it did my knife.
Ah, but I got a better idea. You stand over there. I throw the knife.
Oh no.
Oh yes.
Mascatazita, who asked you? Okay, you stand over there.
Okay. And I'll take a stab at it.
You're trying to earn a living, too. I'm gonna stand over there, and you throw the knife in when I say three. I said, wait a minute! What, you do like this from the West? Take it easy. You gotta wait until I say three. Please. Let me explain again. You gotta wait until I say one, two, three. Yeah, take it easy. That's an okay opening, you know? You got no shame. This cigarette in my mouth. I ain't gonna cut it in half when I say. You know? One, two. You go over there. I'm gonna take care of you nice, okay? One, two, three. Gentlemen, no color. Oh, mama me. How'd you know that was right? Oh, you're only kidding me. Right, oh, my heart beat so fast. I really, when I saw you, I thought the knife went right in.
Jimmy? Why don't you, pull up a piano and sit down, huh?
Well, I don't know, Dean, after what happened to you a couple of minutes ago, I'm not sure I'm covered for a rear-end collision.
Oh. Well, just try it. Nice and easy. Look, see? Up. Go ahead.
All right.
That didn't bite you, did it, huh?
No, not yet.
You know, I can't tell you how happy I am to see you.
Well, it's good seeing you, Dean. You know, we've been neighbors for an awful long time, and we just hardly ever get to see each other.
All you have to do, Jimmy, is drop over. You know, the welcome mat is always out.
I know, Dean, but so are you.
Come on, Jimmy. Everybody loves you, and they want to know all about you. So I'm just going to ask you some questions, you know, nice and easy. Like, how did you get started in show business?
Well, I was right after I graduated from Princeton. And I was asked to play the accordion in a tea room. And after the second night, they fired me.
Why?
Because I was lousy.
Oh. Well, you sure have come a long way since that. You've been nominated for 5 Academy Awards, and you won an Oscar for The Philadelphia Story, and you made some of the best pictures I ever saw. It was a wonderful life, right? Mr. Smith Goes to Washington, Glenn Miller's story, and the one you made with Margaret Sullivan.
Oh, yeah, the Mortal Storm. Mm-hmm. Mortal Storm, yeah. Funny thing about that picture, I remember that very well. That's when I started believing my own publicity.
What do you mean by that?
Well, it's a funny thing, you know, Dane. The way you're thinking, you know, in our business, we sort of lots of times don't stick to the facts and everything. I remember the last scene of that picture, I skied down a very steep mountain, and I picked Margaret Sullivan up in my arms, and then I skied down another big mountain out into the sunset, and that was the end of the picture. Well, the picture was released, and a fella came up to me, and he said, "Gee, Jim, I saw you with that picture with Margaret Sullivan, and I think you did an awful good job of skiing." And I said, no, that was a double. I used a double there. I didn't do any of the skiing, but I thought about that for a while. And then the picture had been out for about 3 months, and people had been asking me about the skiing, and another fella came up and said, I saw you that picture with Margaret Sullivan, and I thought you did a lot of very good skiing. And I said, well, I didn't do all of it. You see how you get into the thing? And then it was on television not very long ago, and a fella came up to me. He said, "I saw the picture you did on Margaret Sullivan on the television and everything. You did very good skiing." And I said, "Well, I learned to ski when I was a kid, you know. It comes back to you. You don't forget it." And you know, to this day, I just think maybe it's hard for me not believe that I didn't do some of that skiing. Dean, do you ever use a double?
Not while I'm working, Jimmy. I know.
I see.
Jimmy, I want to tell you how happy I am to be making a picture with you. You know, Jimmy and I are making a picture called Bandolero. We play a couple of brothers who fought in the Civil War.
You know, my grandfather actually fought in the Civil War.
Yeah?
Well, ain't that a coincidence? My grandfather fell at Gettysburg.
Oh, did?
Yeah, he tripped over that monument.
Oh.
That
big thing.
Hey, I wish you had your accordion here. We could sing and do songs together.
Well, I used to fool around a little on the piano.
Well, let's turn around and fool around with this one, hmm?
Well.
Come on, let's try it.
All right, Dean. Well, I'll tell you, Dean, maybe I'll start out on the only tune I know, and then you sort of jump in whenever you feel it.
All right, whenever I feel it. Okay.
Down in Arizona, where the Badlands are, and the only thing to guide you is the evening star. The roughest, toughest man by far is Ragtime Cowboy Joe. He always sings jazzy music to the cattle as he swings back and forward in the saddle on a horse, a pretty good horse with the syncopated gait. The roar of his repeating such feet, how they run when he fires that gun, so the western folks all know that he's a highfalutin tootin' son of a gun from Arizona. Ragtime cowboy, I talk about Chicago. Ragtime cowboy Joe, let's go. Oh, how they run when he fires that gun, so the western folks all know that he's a highfalutin', rootin', tootin' son of a gun from Arizona. Ragtime cowboy, talk about your cowboy. Ragtime cowboy Joe.
I'm glad you dropped in tonight. Yeah, because the only time I see you and we're not working is at the barber shop.
Oh, yeah, the barber. Mr. Bruce, just a great hairdresser.
Oh, the greatest, I'll tell you that. Now, let me tell you. You know, barber shops ain't what they used to be. Years ago, a barber would throw an apron around you, give you a haircut, and then finish you off with a little stale cologne and some powder on the back of the neck, you know. Nowadays in Hollywood, barbers are out. They got hair stylists. Now we go to the place. Well, you won't believe this place. You won't believe it. Here we go.
Orson, my wife took the car. Can you drop me off at the house?
Sure, Dean, if you don't mind riding with the top down.
That's okay, I'll wear a scarf.
Jimmy, do me a favor. Hand me my cigar, my nails are still wet.
There they are.
Thank you.
What are you reading?
Oh, one of these Hollywood magazines, they kill me. Listen to some of these articles. Does Flipper still get tanked? Here's another one. If you were one of Doris Day's freckles, would you tell?
I'm just reading one by a Hollywood doctor. It's called, Are Your Glands on Friendly Terms? What are you reading, Dean?
Popular Mechanics.
Yeah, get a load of that mechanic. Huh? How'd you like that in the car? Oh.
Dean, did you go to the party last night?
No, I couldn't. I didn't have a thing to wear.
I was there.
How was it?
Well, I'm going to tell you something in the strictest confidence. I don't want you to spill a word of this.
Have you ever known me to spill anything?
Well, Tab and Rock showed up. Both wearing identical blazers.
Wouldn't you just die?
Heavens to Betsy.
Well, they were beautiful blazers, but you know something? I saw the exact same thing downtown for 1995.
Oh, you didn't?
Yeah. Anyway, Phil Harris was there.
Oh, well, how does he look?
I couldn't tell. He was sitting at the bottom of the pool. singing.
Frankly, the last time I saw him, his hair looked awful.
I hate to say this, but I'm afraid Phil's letting himself go.
I think he looks positively frumpy.
I think maybe Phil ought to get a good babysitter and try to get out of the house more.
Well, help's so difficult to get nowadays. I can't find a decent babysitter. I called a bunch last night, you know, Bridget Bardot, Sophia Loren.
You mean you can get girls like that to babysit?
I don't know, but if I do, I'll stay home and send the kids out.
Say, Orson.
Yeah?
Who's working on your hair?
Monique. She's marvelous. Doing a little combing out, straightening, coloring.
Does she do any teasing?
She tries.
Yeah, baby.
I really should be getting home. I put a dent in the fender, and I want to get the car in the garage before Gloria sees it.
Oh, it's so hot under these hot dryers.
I don't know why I go through this every week. Jeannie never notices what I look like anyway.
Gene, I love the way you're doing your hair. Does something for your ears.
Oh, well, thank you, Orson. I just don't know what I'm going to do when Bruce, you know Bruce, when he goes on vacation? I just don't know. I won't let anybody else touch my hair.
I lived in such a rut until my razor cut became the talk of the whole industry. And now the ladies love my personality.
Pants and pompadour was all I ever wore until my barber restyled it for me. And now I've got the cutest personality.
There are certain oils, they can smear in it.
And some of them, they pour beer in it.
And when they get the scotch out,
watch out!
Although they might prefer a quiet manicure, they never mind my refined repartee. I've got an awful lot of personality.
I've already left my antenna since. I finally got my henna rinse.
Can't wait till they marcel me.
Yeah.
Tell me. I'll have my crew cut, Doc.
I'll get my eyebrows plucked.
Oh, what a wonderful day it will be. Well, we'll wind up with a brand new personality. Done by certain girls with facial packs and sausage curls.
They'll really go to town, boy.
Town, boy.
So if you need a shave or just a finger away, they might insist upon doing it free.
If you know how to use your personality.
Silver line whene'er a cloud appears in the blue. Remember somewhere the sun is shining, and so the right thing make it shine for you. A heart full of joy and gladness will always banish sadness and strife. So always look for the silver lining and try to find the sunshine of life. Sunny side.